In order to adjust pitch in Pro Tools, we're going to use this elastic audio component. And this time we're going to set it to polyphonic. So typically we would choose monophonic for a vocal because it is only one note at a time. But for elastic pitch, we're going to need to select this polyphonic algorithm. You can see it'll blink. We've got a little green light next to the algorithm here telling us that we are ready to go. So let's listen to this one passage here. I'm particularly pitchy at the very last note here and a little bit at the beginning as well. So let's see if we can clean this up. Yeah, I need a little lift there at the end. So let's see what we can do. First things first is you want to isolate the regions or the areas in the regions that you do want to pitch. So I'm going to zoom in here and find where the first syllable happens. And I'm going to go into slip mode for this. Looks like right there is where I change. So I'm highlighting the area that I want to isolate, and I'm using the key command, command E, to separate this into its own distinct clip. And then again, for the last note here, I'm going to do the same thing. Command E. Next thing we want to do is to access the elastic properties, which we're going to find in the clip menu here. I'm just going to select elastic properties, and then here we have this menu. So I'll place it right here so we can see everything that's happening. The two main areas you're going to want to look for are these two boxes in the pitch shift part of this menu. So here we have semitones, which is equivalent to a half step. So if there were two semitones, it would be a whole step. So you can pitch things up drastically if you were like exactly a semitone under pitch. You could easily pitch things up. Or you can adjust by cents, which is a much more granular measurement that's kind of in between pitches. So let's take a listen to this first clip. First, let's try a semitone and see what happens. So I'm going to just go to one semitone. So that's too much. So back to zero. I think I just needed a little bit of height here. So I'm going to notch it up maybe 16 cents and we'll see what happens. I think that did help, actually. And let's take a look at this one as well. I think I might have been an entire half step below. So I'm just adding, I just typed in one into this pitch shift area. And let's hear what this sounds like. Too much. So again, gonna go back to zero here. And then I'm gonna bump this up maybe 30 cents and we'll see how that adjusts. So this is sounding considerably better. Let's back it up and listen to the whole phrase now. A lot better. So you can see you can do this sort of piece by piece tuning. And if you're not making huge sweeping gestures of adjustments across a whole vocal, and you just need to nudge a few notes, this can be a really easy and fast way to fix them inside of Pro Tools.